My name is Fatima Helmy. I'm an educator since 13 years ago, and I'm a teacher and head of Islamic and Social Studies Department at Al Yasmina Academy, my lovely school. I'm also a mom of 6 children. I'm actually now pregnant, so I'm a teacher at school and also a teacher at home with this amount of children. Today, inshallah, I will speak in Arabic and try to translate in English as I can because my language is not so good. But I'm aim to give this speech or live for Islamic teachers native. So how to apply the collaborative learning through the distance learning or the hybrid learning? Let me start. محاور البث في هذا اليوم هو كيفية تطبيق مجموعات تعاونية في التعلم عن بعد في حصص التربية الإسلامية. أيضا سنتطرق في النهاية إلى أدوات تكنولوجية تعاونية بتساعدني أنا شخصيا في حصة التربية الإسلامية في كيفية تطبيق التعلم التعاوني. Why it's important to apply collaborative learning? أول شيء لأنه بيجعل الطالب محور العملية التعليمية. The student will be the center of the learning process. Also, بتخفف الرهبة من الخطأ أو من التعلم عند الطلاب. Reduce the amount of afraid of doing something mistake or doing something wrong when they work together. Also, بتحسن مستوى التحصيل عند الطلاب. The achievement will be better when the student work together collaboratively. كذلك بتؤدي إلى تبادل الخبرات وتنمية المهارات خصوصا مهارات التواصل وإحنا بنحتاج هذا الشيء كثير في التعلم عن بعد حاليا. What do we need to apply collaborative learning? We need three things. بنحتاج 3 شغلات عشان نقدر نطبق التعلم التعاوني. رقم 1 نحتاج مجموعات عمل group work. محتاجين مكان الطلاب يقدروا يتجمعوا فيه أو نقسمهم فيه. محتاجين كمان communication tools أو وسيلة للتواصل والمناقشات الطلاب بيقدروا يتواصلوا فيها مع بعض وينقلوا أفكارهم. كذلك بنحتاج مستندات تعاونية بيشاركوا فيها نتائج المناقشات والتعاون اللي احنا بنسميها بالإنجليش collaborative documents أو online documents بيقدروا الطلاب reflect their learning at the end. طيب أنا عندي طريقة كتير اعتمدتها وعجبتني كتير مع طلابي في المرحلة الثانوية وكمان تصلح للمرحلة الابتدائية إذا كانت المدرسة تستخدم مايكروسوفت تيمز. كذلك إذا كنتوا تستخدموا الزوم كمان في عنا شيء اسمه بريك أوت رومز أو الشانلز في المايكروسوفت تيمز. في المايكروسوفت تيمز زي ما أنتم شايفين هون الصف أنا قسمته إلى شانلز. I divide my class to channels. Each channel I put some students or set some groups, small groups for students, and I ask them to join these channels after when I want them to collaborate together or to do a collaborative work. As you see here, I name the student مجموعة أبو بكر الصديق, مجموعة عمر بن الخطاب, مجموعة علي بن أبي طالب, and I have also another channels for the based on the ability of students hot, sour, spicy, and sour. في إرشادات مهمة كتير إنه يكون في عندك روتين في العمل التعاوني. يمكن ما بيزبط معك من أول مرة بس إذا عملت هذا الروتين إن شاء الله هتلاقي كتير في تطور في العمل التعاوني عند طلابك. What is the instructions to set the collaborative work through the channels or team channels or Zoom breakout rooms? First of all, you need to divide the student or to set them into small groups. After that, make sure that your instructions is so clear and you put it, in a, for example, through announcement post on Teams. You need to set a leader for a group, a writer, a speaker for a group, and make sure that you give all part of the groups a work or a task to do. Allow to the leader of a group to start video call with their friend, their his group, and to make sure that all the group is online in the same time. Make sure that you put any document, any online document they can share or they can document or write or type the result of the discussion. As a teacher, you need to move from channel to channel to make sure that everything is good and to support the low ability student group if you have, if you set groups based on the abilities. After that, at the end of the lesson or the collaboration time, ask students all to come together in the general channel to start show their result or their work and start take feedback or feedback each other at that time. So this is the main steps for how we apply the collaboration or collaborative work through Teams. But we have also another educational tools that allow students to work together when they are distance learning or hybrid learning. I always use Flipgrid, maybe before also the COVID-19 and the situation. I always use it as a collaboration space also to allow students to discuss together or to debate. Sometimes I give students a situation and I ask them which opinion do you agree with, and I ask him to take the opposite opinion and start to debate and start to discuss with the student to let them agree with him. So we start like that with Flipgrid. As you see, sometimes I don't know if you will listen or no, I give them a topic, a hot topic in Islamic, and I ask them to start videoing themselves and start to feedback each other by video. And I found this also very useful for recitation. When they recite Quran, because I can't see them, so I ask them to give me the recitation, and they start also feedback each other through Flipgrid. I also love working with Padlet. You have many formats on Padlet. I like to use this format. So I can sit here, as you see, in two groups, for example, and I link the student to this group, and they will start to work together, as you see in the screen. And also, I like it for the youngest student. They can record their voices. They can record video if they are struggling on language, like we are facing this in our school, especially for native students. I like also the concept board. It's a very lovely tool that allow all students and allow you as a teacher to see what the student write, because they, as you see, I will show you the video. As you see, the name of a student or the group, and you know how they all collaborate together in the same time, in online time. You can sit this link also to the students through CISO if you are not using live sessions. So it's so useful to allow all students together to see what each student do. Also, I used to work or to set Mindomo. It's also like a mind map to students. I put it in the channels, as you see here, and I ask a student when they discuss to try that the writer to try to type or to try to gather the information or the result, what the result of the discussion. Also, the project-based learning, it's so useful for this time. As you know, Adek, last 2 years, she cancelled the exam of Ministry of Education for year 12, and she allowed us to set the student project. I set the student project and linked the project to the topics of Islamic with their life. So I choose the hot topic now, the COVID-19, and ask a student to connect Hadi Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam fi riaya sahiya with what they saw now or what they challenge now in COVID-19. After that, ask student to join small groups and to set some times to to try to come together to discuss and to see what where they are in their project after they put tasks for each other. And at the end, they need to present in front of all this, the class to debate or to discuss the final discussion, and after that, evaluate each other. I suggest here some tools for collaborative documents like class notebook, OneNote, Google Docs, and Office 365, the online PowerPoint, Word, and Quib, also nearby. Here also another suggestion for collaborative tools. You can take snapshot for this tools, and you can try each month trying some new collaborative tools. And that's it. I hope I'm not taking many time. If you have any question, you can send me through my email. Thank you.